Welcome you all to this session on resistance switching in circuit breakers. First, let us see what is meant by resistance switching. So, whenever a fault occurs, the contacts of the circuit breaker gets separated. When it gets separated, an arc is formed between the circuit breaker contacts. So, this arc current is very high. So what has to be done? The arc has to be quenched. So by a suitable insulating medium, either a gas or a liquid, the arc is quenched. So when the arc is quenched, a very high voltage appears across the circuit breaker contacts, which is known as the restriking voltage. So to reduce this restriking voltage, we connect a resistance across the circuit breaker contacts. So these are nothing but the contacts of the circuit breaker. We connect a resistance along with the spear gap across the circuit breaker contacts. So this is known as resistance switching. So the way in which we connect the resistance across the circuit breaker so that our arc current follows the path of this resistance, we call it as resistance switching. So what will happen when we connect a resistance across the circuit breaker contacts? You have an arc which is present, okay? We have an arc across this circuit breaker contacts. So what happens is, if a resistance is connected, the arc current gets divided through this resistance. So what will happen? The current at this point reduces, that is the arc current reduces, whereas the current through this resistance will increase. Okay, so due to this decrease in the arc current, the restriking voltage and the RRRV, that is rate of rise of restriking voltage, is reduced. What will happen if the current through this resistance is increased? So it will automatically get switched in with the help of this spear gap. So we have to find what is the value of the resistance to be connected across the circuit breaker contacts so that we can reduce the restriking voltage. We can reduce the severity of the transient oscillation which is occurring. So to obtain the value of this resistance, we will consider a circuit for its analysis. This is the circuit for analysis of resistance switching. The voltage source here is E. We can even write it as V. So we know that this circuit over here is a purely reactive circuit. So the maximum value of the voltage occurs at omega t equal to 0. So the voltage source, we will write it as Vm cos omega t. So since the period of the transient oscillation is very small, we will assume cos omega t equal to 1 so that our voltage source is constant with the value Vm. And you can observe these are the contacts of the circuit breaker, and the resistance R is connected across the contacts of the circuit breaker. So to obtain the value of R and to obtain the frequency of the damped oscillation, we have to apply KVL and KCL to this particular circuit. So if you apply KVL to this first loop, what we get is Vm. Why Vm? Because Vm cos omega t, we take it as Vm. So Vm is equal to L di by dt plus Vc. Vc is nothing but Vc. So we can write that as Vm is equal to L di by dt plus Vc is 1 by C integral Ic dt. This is the first equation that is obtained by applying KVL. So you can observe here we have the currents, that is I. It is split into two, IC and IR. So we will write the expression for the current, that is by applying KCL, I is equal to IC plus IR. So this is the first equation what we need, that is by applying the voltage, and this is the second equation what we need to find the value of resistance R. So these two equations, we will find the frequency of the damped oscillation and the shunt resistance what is need to be connected for resistance switching. So let us rewrite that equation what we have written. L di by dt plus 1 by C integral IC dt is equal to Vm, or and the second one is I is equal to IC plus IR. So this I is equal to IC plus IR we will substitute in the equation above. So we get L into d by dt of IC plus IR plus this 1 by C integral IC dt, for time being we will write it as VC, that is equal to Vm. So this can be written as L dIC by dt plus L dIR by dt plus VC is equal to Vm. Okay, so what is IC? IC is nothing but the change in the charge, that is rate of change of charge. So we will write that as IC is equal to dq by dt, wherein q we can write in terms of capacitance, d is into q is c into vc divided by dt, so that dIC by dt becomes d square c into vc divided by dt, or c is constant, we can take it out, we can write it as d square vc by dt square. Similarly, dIR by dt can be written as d of, so the current through the resistance, that is the resistance which is connected across the contact of the circuit breaker. So under the open condition of the circuit breaker, the voltage across that resistance is nothing but the voltage across the capacitance. If you look into the circuit, you can clearly observe it. So VC by R divided by DT, or you can write it as 1 by R dVC by DT. So that on substituting that in the equation, whatever dIC by dt and dIR by dt what we have got, if you substitute back in the equation, what we get is L, this equation L dIC by dt plus L dIR by dt plus VC equal to Vm. In this equation, we have to substitute whatever dIC by dt and dIR by dt we have got, so that we can write dIC by dt is c into d square vc by dt square plus L dIR by dt is 1 by r, so this becomes L by r into dvc by dt plus vc equal to Vm. So now what we need, we need the value of r. Okay, so that what we do is, this is in time domain, we apply Laplace, convert it into frequency domain, and then we will find the value of R. So apply Laplace to this. So taking Laplace, we get L into C, D square means it is S square, VC by T, it becomes VC of S plus L by R, D by DT is nothing but S into VC of S plus VC of S is equal to Vm by S. So we take common here, we take LC and VC of S out. So we get LC into VC of S if we take it out. In this we are remaining with S square plus L is there. So this has to be 1 by RC into S plus 1 by LC. This is equal to Vm by S. So now we rearrange this. We get Vc of S is equal to Vm divided by S LC into S square plus 1 by RC into S plus 1 by LC. So for the transient oscillations to be zero, all the roots of the equation should be real. That means we have SLC, this should be equal to zero. That means S is equal to zero, which is real. For we have remaining two roots from this quadratic equation, this should also be real. That means for this roots to be real, for this quadratic equation, the condition is B square minus 4AC should be greater than or equal to 0. So which is B here? The coefficient of this is A, this is B, and this is C. So B square means it is 1 by RC the whole square, square minus 4, A is 1, C is 1 by LC, this should be greater than or equal to 0. So what we get here is 1 by R square C square minus 4 by LC is greater than or equal to 0. That means 1 by R square C square is greater than or equal to 4 by LC, or R square should be less than or equal to LC by 4C square. So the C and C get cancelled. So R square should be less than or equal to L by 4C, or we can rewrite this as R square should be less than or equal to 1 by 4 into L by C. So that our R should be less than or equal to 1 by 2 root L by C. So if we look into this equation, if the value of the resistance is less than or equal to half root L by C, there will be no oscillations. Okay. There will be no transient oscillations. Whereas if the resistance is greater than half root L by C, then there will be transient oscillations. Okay, so R equal to 1 by 2 root L by C, we call it as a critical resistance. Okay, this is the critical resistance. So if the resistance value is less than that, there is no oscillation. If it is greater, transient oscillation. So this is nothing but the critical value of the resistance. So if you can observe the transient oscillations for different values of R. So this is where R is infinity. This is where it is greater than the condition what we have obtained. That means there will be transients. If it is less than, that means there is no transient oscillations. So R equal to 1 by 2 root L by C is the critical value of resistance. So the frequency of the damped oscillation, we can write it as F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root 1 by LC minus 1 by 4 C square R square. This is the frequency of the damped oscillation. So we can connect a resistance so in order to reduce the restriking voltage and RRRV. Thank you for watching this video.